Hello everyone. In the last class we studied about Pythagoras theorem as well as some of the problems based on that Pythagoras theorem. Today let us continue some of the problems. Now next problem, in your textbook, I am always referring the central syllabus textbook. The same book is adopted by the state board 2, Karnataka state board 2. Now 13th example they have given like this. BN and CN are the medians of a triangle ABC. Right angled at A. Prove that 4 times BL square plus CM square is equal to 5BC square. BL and CM are the medians of a right angled triangle ABC. So I draw right angled at A. So A, B, C. BL and CM. So right angled at A. So I write down BL and CM are the medians. What is the meaning of medians? Medians divides the base into two equal parts. See, CL is equal to LA because of this BL. AM is equal to MB because of that CM. That is the meaning of median. Now they have asked 4 times BL square plus CM square. Now whenever I draw like this, I get 3 right angled triangles. Let us write down that. Then let us see whether we can prove that. So first one is, what is that? In right angled triangle ABC, in right angled triangle ABC, angle A is equal to 90, right? Therefore, BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square. Now, in right angled triangle ALM, ALB, ALB, this is 90 degree. So, angle LAB is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, I can say BL square is equal to AL square plus AB square. Again, in right angled triangle, there are 3 right angled triangles, ACM, angle CAM is equal to 90, therefore CM square is equal to AC square plus AM square. Right? See, look at this. I want BL square plus CM square. I call this as 1, I call this as 2, and call this as 3. Now what can I say? Adding 2 and 3, adding 20, what do I get? BL square plus CM square is equal to, this is the left hand side. In the right hand side, what is A? BL square is, I write down here, AL square plus AB square plus AC square plus AM square. AC square plus AM square. But what is AB square plus AC square? BC square. So I write down, instead of this I write down BC square. So AL square plus AM square plus BC square. See, I have now results every time I have to see. BL square, CM square, BC square is A. This one is extra. Can I write down AL as? How can I write down AL? AL is here. How can I write down AL? Half of AC. So I can say half of AC the whole square plus what is AM? Half of AB the whole square plus BC square. Do you agree? What is half of AC the whole square? 1 by 4 AC square plus 1 by 4 AB square plus BC square. So I think 1 by 4 is common. I take out AC square plus AB square plus BC square. This is equal to 1 by 4 AC square plus AB square is BC square plus BC square. So what do I get? get, I have this, I get bn square plus cm square is equal to 1 by 4 bc square plus bc square. 1 by 4 bc square plus bc square is 5 by 4 bc square. Correct? So, bn square plus cm square is equal to 5 by 4 bc square. Cross multiplication. 4 times bn square plus cm square is equal to 5 bc square. Did we get the answer? That is all. So, whenever we get like that, using that 90 degree, how many triangles it has formed, you see, and later you will understand how to proceed. I hope you understand. Well, let's move to the next problem. Our next problem is like this. O is any point inside a rectangle ABCD. Prove that OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. O is any point inside the rectangle. I have drawn the rectangle ABCD. I write down draw O anyway. What I have to prove? OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. What I have to prove? OA square plus OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. This square comes only when I apply Pythagoras theorem. So in order to get Pythagoras theorem, let me do a small construction. I draw a line parallel to BC which passes through this. So I write down as PQ. PQ is a line which is parallel to BC, parallel to AD. You know these two lines are parallel. When it is parallel to this, it has to be parallel to this also. Right? So then when I draw like this, this one will be 90, this one will be 90. Here also 90, here also 90. Right? So I get four right-angled triangles. Let me start one by one. Here, which is that in right-angled triangle OPA, see this is 90, so OA square angle OPA is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, I write down OA square is equal to AP square plus OP square. OA square is equal to AP square plus OP square. I call it as 1. Like that, in right angle triangle OPB, you write down angle OPB is equal to, in right angle triangle OPB, angle OPB is equal to 90. Therefore, OP square is equal to OP square plus PB square. Again, in right angle triangle OCQ, angle OQC is equal to 90. Therefore, OC square is equal to OQ square plus QC square. In right angle triangle ODQ, ODQ, angle OQD is equal to 90. Therefore, OD square is equal to OQ square plus OQ square plus QD square. Right? Now, OB square is equal to OA square is equal to AP square plus OP square. OB square is equal to BP square plus OP square. We have written all that. Right? I call this as 1, call this as 2, call this as 3, call this as 4. Now what is my aim? That I have to see every time. I want OB square plus OD square. So I add 2 and 4. Adding 2 and 4, 2 plus 4 gives, what is that 2? OB square plus OD square is equal to, what is OB square? OP square plus PB square plus, what is OD square? OQ square plus QD square. Now OP square plus OD square, OP square, that will be like that. OP square plus PP square. Can I write down PP as QC? Yes, QC square. Why? They are the opposite sides of the rectangle, and this is parallel to this, so this one should be equal to this. QC square plus OQ square, let it be like that, plus QD square. What can I write down QD square as? AP square. So AP square. Now look at the one. What is one? They have given AP square plus OP square. So my aim is to get OA square plus OC square, right? So AP square and OP square I'll put together. OP square plus AP square plus OQ square plus QC square I'll write down together. What is OP square plus AP square? OA square. Plus what is OQ square plus QC square? OC square. So I got the answer. What is that? OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. So simple. So you understood that. Now, let me solve some of the questions from the textbook. Your first question is like this. Sides of the triangles are given below. Determine which of them are right triangle. In case of a right triangle, write the length of its hypotenuse. Whenever they give the question like this, you have to use the converse of Pythagoras theorem. What does the converse of Pythagoras say? If in a triangle, the square on the longest side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, then those two sides contain a right angle. So whenever they give the three sides, pick up the longest one, find out the square, and see whether it is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. If it is so, then it is a right angle triangle. If it is no, then it is not a right angle triangle. Let us see the example. Example 1, you look at that. What is the first one they have given? 7, 24, 25. This is the method you have to do. Out of these three, which is the biggest one? 25. So what is 25 square? 625. What is the next step? You have to add 7 square plus 24 square. What is 7 square? 49 plus what is 24 square? 576. 576 plus 49? 625. Are they equal? Yes, then it is a rectangle triangle. Now let me solve the second one. 3, 8 and 6 centimeter they have given. Which is the longest one? 8. So what is 8 square? 64. Which are the other two? 3 and 6. 3 square plus 6 square. What is 3 square? 9 plus 36. How much? 45. Are they equal? No, then it is not a right angle triangle. Did you all understand? So, hence you have to conclude that it is not a right angle triangle. Like that, they have given another two questions. You please work out. Now, if you like my video, please share it with others and subscribe. Thank you very much.